I find it hard to work in any job without having an almost unattainable goal. At the foundational level, the devices we use to compute are radically different than regular computers.
Quantum computing is where the new laws of physics that was discovered in quantum physics can be applied to process information in ways that our traditional computers cannot.
Quantum centers are springing up like weeds all over the world. So at Duke, we are standing up a quantum center that's actually unlike any other quantum center I know of. And it's really going to build devices. We call it a vertical center. That is, we're going to build the quantum hardware, build software around it, and actually use it. And then learning how it's used, that'll help us build the next generation. I think over the next 10 years, universities and national labs will play an absolutely crucial role in getting more people using these things for whatever means. They're not constrained by making sure that they can sell.
When a new technology becomes practically useful to become an industry, there's always a huge demand for academics to play a role. But when internet first came about, there was nobody doing internet research in universities. But today there's a lot, because they need people to think about new ways to innovate in that space and also train the next generation workforce to actually continue the push for industry.
To make a quantum computer, you need some piece of material that maintains its quantum properties very well. So at Duke, we focus on trapped ion quantum computing, and every quantum bit is a single trapped atomic ion. And we control that ion using lasers and microwave frequencies to be able to talk to its internal quantum states and get them to connect together to make these waves of numbers. You can kind of imagine, like, if you drop a rock in a pond, it forms these waves, and then the waves hit the posts that hold up a dock. And at each of those posts, it splits into more waves. And then you see those waves interfere. So what a quantum computer does is it starts with this one number. It then splits it into this wave of many numbers. It interferes these waves and many numbers in very different ways so that it comes back at the end to one number, which is ideally your answer.
So there are classes of problems out there that we ignore now because we can't touch them. And so these are what quantum computers would be able to do.
But if you're looking for solutions, there is like one good solution out of infinitely many possibilities. That seems to be an area where quantum computers can potentially excel extremely well, like way, way beyond classical computers.
When you put people together in the same place physically, it just kind of accelerates research in a new way. So I'm really excited to be a part of that kind of fast-paced environment, and so where we can feed off of each other and really move the research forward.
And I think that that's a very Duke thing. Right? Because, you know, we tell ourselves stories about how we're a great interdisciplinary place. But really, being a great interdisciplinary place is about people doing things together that they couldn't do by themselves. Next 10 years is where quantum computers move out of physics labs and into the real world.
We want to do algorithms. We don't want to do atomic physics anymore. We're done, kind of done with that. We're thinking higher level.
If you're a university and you aspire to be a leader in that field, you have to make a big bet. Because basically, if you make a small bet, it doesn't matter. I am super pleased that Duke decided to make a big bet.